Hey guys, so today we'll be counting down our most memorable moments on paranormal investigations. Let us know what you think in the comment sections below, and let us know if you have any memorable moments you'd like to share with us as well.
Coming in at number 3 for the most memorable moment I've had while on a paranormal investigation happened at Trivette Clinic in Harmony, North Carolina. Nick, Greg, and myself were up in the red room at Trivette Clinic, and we were all sitting there waiting for the homeowners to leave. They have a gravel driveway, and so it's really loud, and you can hear it on the audio recorder. So we gave them a couple minutes to get their car out of the driveway so that you wouldn't hear the gravel noise on our audio. And while that was happening, Greg heard something that Nick and I didn't hear at the time. A couple seconds later, the noise happened again, and the only way I can describe it is a really loud shuffling or rustling noise, almost like a plastic bag or furniture moving or something. And so we all waited for it to stop. My jaw was on the floor because of how loud it was, and it lasted like 20 or 30 seconds. Then we all got up and we started looking around trying to figure out what could have made that noise and tried to recreate it. We were moving furniture, shuffling the bedding, moving curtains, opening closets, looking for anything that could have caused this, and we couldn't find anything and we couldn't recreate it. To this day, that is still one of the loudest and craziest sounds I've ever heard, and amazing that we caught it on video.
Coming in at number 2, and definitely my most memorable moment, happened on the USS North Carolina, the battleship in Wilmington. So I was carrying the shoe-mounted camera and I was walking through, and there's a section of the ship that goes below deck from the first level to the second level. And we were specifically told not to use that staircase. Yeah, so I walked up with my camera, and since I couldn't actually go down below deck, I decided to stick my camera down just to kind of see if I could get a quick shot of it. And as I did, I lifted my camera over a chain that was blocking the entrance to the hole. I stuck my arm over the chain and something grabbed me in two different spots, and it actually really hurt. Something like jammed its thumb into my elbow, and then another, it felt like a hand grabbed my hand where I was holding the camera, almost like it was telling me, you know, stop, don't come down here, don't film us, don't point your camera at us, etc. It really hurt. Like I literally thought I had jammed my arm into something metal because it was dark. There were no lights on besides the light from my camera. So I just thought I had not seen something. I had jammed my arm into it, but after reviewing the tape and kind of taking a second, I realized there was nothing else there. It was literally my arm just went through the air and something interfered with it in two different spots. It hurt really bad, but I didn't get the vibe that it was something malicious or trying to hurt me, because if it was trying to hurt me, it would have pushed me down the steps. It would have done something else. It just seemed like it didn't want to be bothered and it didn't want me to go down below into that part of the ship, so it stopped us.
Coming in at number 1, and by far my most memorable moment of our paranormal investigations, took place at Trivette Clinic in Harmony, North Carolina. We've been to Trivette quite a few times, and it's definitely one of my favorite places to investigate, just because of how small it is, and it's only about 30 minutes away from where we all live. So we go there, I would say, probably once every few months, and it's also on the cheaper side. This took place towards the end of our investigation that night. There were about 4 of us that went that night, and so things were starting to wind down. We had had some occurrences happen earlier on in the night, but we were upstairs. We were spread out. Some were in the red room, and then I was in the doll room. I don't particularly like the doll room. Last time we were there, or the time before this one, I had seen what looked like maybe a little kid in there, and so I finally ventured in there just because things were starting to calm down and I didn't think anything was going to happen, even though we'd been hearing stuff coming from that room. And so there's a little bed where all the dolls sit on, and I just decided to lay back on it. And I think we were asking a few questions just to finish out the night, and it felt like somebody just came from behind me, and it was almost like just put 2 fingers on each side of my neck and just started squeezing, and it just felt really light and almost like a spider web was on the back of my neck. So at the time it happened, Emily had been filming throughout the night, and so suddenly I just jumped up and ran out of the room and started screaming, of course, because something had just grabbed my neck. But at the same time, our other 2 investigators said that they heard something coming from up the stairs that was just around the corner from the room. So by now I've been on tons of paranormal investigations. I've heard footsteps, I've heard voices, I've heard the EVPs we've captured. I've seen a couple of shadows, made out maybe a small apparition, but by far this is the event that I'll definitely remember the most, just because I could almost just feel two fingers on my neck distinctly.
That's it. Something to that extent. Hello.
I'm sorry, I did not mean to distract.
You're good?
You're not the first person that's done it tonight, actually, so.
Well, we have a class over there, and I didn't want the teacher to see me leaving, so
I had to. Hey, no worries, we understand. Case. Not damn how loud your shoes be.
It was fine when it was just like anybody else walking.
This took place towards.
That was for the my favorite part of my grade.
It's alright, I would have messed up anyway.